Mario Maker is brilliant. It's a great family game where I get to make devious stages for my eldest daughter to navigate, and where she can make me coin heaven stages. It's a great game dev tool. It's a celebration of an entire history of platforming gold. And for me, it's a celebration of aesthetics and styles. And an opportunity to cash in on Mario Maker 2's popularity. In Mario Maker 2, we're presented with five or more different Marios throughout history, which means we're presented with five or more differently animated Marios. How do they differ? Or more specifically, how has Mario's run changed over time? Well, let's have a look in this episode of Video Game Animation Study with me, Dan Root. We'll stick mainly to the Mario Maker entries with a few other games added in. Otherwise, we would be here literally all day, and I've got tea to drink, armchairs to doze in, and dad jokes to crack. It's kind of interesting that Mario Maker 2 has added a new style, 3D World, as I feel that the different styles almost align with the progression of Mario's run, splitting things up mainly into 2D, 2.5D, and 3D. Okay, let's start studying right at the beginning, let's start here. So as I've mentioned in my keyframes video, as has the brilliant New Frame Plus, in these limited early days, it's all about strong keyframes to efficiently portray movement as interestingly as possible. What's interesting to consider here, even as early on as the first Super Mario Bros., is that Mario has both a walk and a run cycle using the same set of frames, and that you must slowly build momentum up to a run from standing still. It's pretty simple, the frames loop slowly when walking, with your horizontal speed quite slow, and then when you hold B for the rest of the game, the frames begin to loop quicker, and your horizontal speed quickly peaks to its maximum. I mean, there's nothing particularly special for me to say here other than Mario's run looks like a goofy little scuttle, which is a great thing. He looks like he's getting a shuffle on when regular, and then when he's super, he's kind of got this locomotion feel. It's good. It's clear and concise, as all things should be. Next is my favourite example, Super Toki Mario Panic 2. Here, Mario literally has two frames for running, one of which doubles as his idle pose. Is that lazy or efficient? Same as before, slow loop speed with slow horizontal speed, and both increase when you run. There's a cute little bob to the run, and what I like about this run, and something we'll come back to later, is how Mario rests his hands by his hips instead of pumping them like previously. There's something very Tom and Jerry about it, which draws this into a much more cartoony aesthetic, and doesn't necessarily mean that less frames means less information. Even clearer and conciser. Mario 3 is where things become a little more interesting. Wait, hang on. Yeah, okay. What's interesting is he now has a separate group of three frames for walking, and a separate group of three for running at top speed. Yeah, he has a top speed now. The walking one retains the hands by the hip when super and is more similar to Mario 1 when regular, whereas the running one now has him spread his arms like he's about to take off into the air like a bloody raccoon or something. I like how there's no bouncing at this top speed, given this sense that he's gliding along from the sheer speed like a Looney Tune. Guess I better mention these two or something. Mario Land 1 is basically the same idea as Mario 1, and Mario Land 2 is the same idea as Mario 3, just without the top speed frames. Super Mario World gives us a little more variation by having two frames for regular Mario's run, and an extra frame for when he's super. This feels much more like Mario 2's run cycle, with the two frames and a head bob, which is fitting considering Ninji and Pokey make a return in this game as well. When he's big, there's this little three-frame loop which I call a hiccup cycle, and this accentuates the head bob. And we're keeping the arms spread out when at top speed from before, which honestly looks great. It feels like he's bounding across the ground now, and there's a proper sense of fun when Mario runs, and I love it. Mario World feels like a combination of Mario 2 and Mario 3's running animation. Okay, so Mario 64 is where things change a lot. You now get to see Mario from any and every angle, which means it has to look good from any and every angle. You know, now it has to make more anatomical sense. With the increased moveset in this game, the run button has been removed, so moving around has been resigned to just the analog stick, resulting in a variation of movement depending on how far you press the stick, from creeping to walking to running. Without the run button means no additional top speed can be reached, so his outstretched arms are absent for this game. But that's okay, this game isn't so much about running quickly to the end of the level anymore than it is about precision and jumping and everything. It all feels much more like his hectic little scuttle from Mario 1, with his sticky out arms flailing madly rather than by his side, and a cute little frantic head bob. There's also a little delay to when he starts moving from when you press a direction. It doesn't take as long to reach top speed as it does in previous games, and his running animation doesn't seem to speed up or slow down depending on how fast he's actually moving. It's just that constant cycle from setting off. There aren't any super mushrooms in this game, so Mario is regular size throughout the whole thing, meaning he's much squatter than we're used to, and this affects his anatomy and how he moves, particularly with his stumpy little legs and arms which don't really bend at all, at least not beyond how they've been rigged. This is what contributes to his little flailing arms, by having them stick out rather than by his side. Mario leans now too, both forward and to the side when turning, and it's really cool. It really feels like Mario's a weighty character and not just a video game avatar. All in all, you get the sense that Mario's a bit of a makeshift hero from this run. He's got a place to be and he wants to get there quickly, but it's not particularly elegant, and he's just doing what he needs to in the way that he knows how. Super Mario Sunshine keeps the run from 64, but it's been refined and is less frantic. And he seems a bit calmer, probably because he's got his sleeves rolled up and he's on bloody holiday. For instance, the head bob and that scuttling effect is reduced, resulting in a much smoother run. He appears to lean a little more forward now, probably because he has Flood on his back. His arms seem a little longer too. This might help calm that hectic flailing from 64. Also, his legs are doing much more work, pretty much clearing the floor on the up pose. I like this run. I feel like this is kind of better than 64's one, personally. Paper Mario is considerably different in design, with characters having bigger heads, the paper gimmick and style, the RPG element to it all. His run cycle is stripped back to that of Mario 2's running animation, consisting of roughly two frames and no other movement than the legs. The Thousand Year Door and Super Paper Mario keep this practically the same, except there's many more frames that achieve this same movement with added easing to keep it looking the same as the N64 version. These games are much more their own thing though, and I wouldn't really consider this a particular influence on further run cycle. Mario Galaxy carries forward the running animation from Sunshine. What? Yeah, I know it's Mario Galaxy 2. Though we now have what appears to be a quicker scuttle as he begins, which takes longer to get going, and it slows to a normal pace as he actually gets moving. I think this is the first time I actually noticed Mario's arms seeming longer, much longer than his legs anyway, and the arcs are longer and ganglier now, and it gives the run a bit more energy while keeping that cheeky scuttle calm as well. By this time, Mario has split into 3D games and 2.5D games with the New Super Mario series. So, New Super Mario Bros. For the DS did some weird stuff for Mario's run. As it's inspired by the classic 2D games and functions the same, we now have the run button back, but the models used are based heavily on Mario's modern look in the 3D games. This results in some updated animations, so the initial walk build-up is really scatty and frantic, like it seems too quick for how fast he's moving across screen, and it looks a bit weird. I'm not sure why they didn't reuse some walking animations from previous 3D games, but, you know. It looks like he's running quickly, but it's actually walking speed, and it looks massively off. It's almost like walking was an afterthought because they assume everyone has the run button pressed down forever. The flailing arms return from the 3D games, but as the view is always from the side now, this also seems a little crazy to look at because he always keeps them straight, but the front arm sticks out horizontally while the back arm sort of does a swinging arc when coming up. It's weird. Like, both arms are a bit different in swinging, and I don't really get it. The top speed idea returns thanks to the run button, but instead of a gliding dash with arms outstretched, he now leans forward heavily with his arms pointing back behind him, which we've all seen before. And his legs actually have a nice shape going on, I quite like them. I mean, this all still works. He still comes across as a bit of a mad little fellow trying to get to where he needs to be, however he needs to get there. I'm not quite sure, but I think the fact there's an optional run button meant they had to introduce a faster running animation which wasn't present in the 3D games. So, while we're used to seeing Mario running like this, we now have to be familiar with this. The following new Super games essentially carry this animation over, just with higher detailed models. But it feels smoother than the DS version, so maybe it was just the fidelity that made it look more janky to me, I don't know. A caveat to this is that New Super Mario Bros. 2 brought back the Super Leaf, meaning Mario could fly, and this in turn brought back the arms outstretched idea as well as the arms pointing back. So we had a couple of animations for top speed running, which is nice. While in Raccoon mode, Mario has a slightly different running animation at the beginning with his hands by his hips, kind of reminiscent of Mario 2 and Mario World. I like this, and personally would like to see this sort of run attempted in future Mario games. This is also something we'll come back to. We'll come back to it at the same point I said we'd come back to something else earlier in the video. It's like killing two points with the same comeback or something. Okay, so technically Mario 3D World comes next and then Odyssey, but I'm doing these two out of order because 3D World is a bit of a special case and I want to save it to last. Odyssey seems to be the perfected version of all previous 3D games. He's got the energy and smoothness of 64, Sunshine and Galaxy combined. He's got that scuttle that lacks elegance, the head bob with a purpose, his little flailing arms to propel his body forward, that initial startup scamper, a new nose wobble. His hat moves up and down, that makes me think of when you jump in Mario World. Even though there's not a run button, you can still gain more speed when coming out of a roll, running down a hill, or landing from a leap. And this causes Mario to stick his arms out again, like those older games. And it feels really nice and playful when he does. And all the while, you get this feeling that he's simply in a hurry to get to the shops because he needs to buy some bread and milk. It's like a dart. He's darting to get out of the rain or something. I just love this goofy little man's run animation. Runimation. This is how I want Mario to move. So, why is 3D World different? 3D World is pretty much the closest thing we have to a 3D version of a classic 2D Mario game. Aside from Super Mario 3D Land, which came before it. But I'm using 3D World because 3DS footage is really difficult to get. He has a lot of moves from the main 3D games, but this feels like a 2D Mario game. Right down to having a smaller Mario when low on health and the flagpole ending. Probably why it was a welcome addition to the 2D Mario Maker franchise. You know what else is from the 2D games? A run button! The running animation for 3D World is unlike all 3D games before it. You see, while Mario's building up his speed, you've got your average sort of thing going on, fine. Mario doing a little more leaning forward, less hectic than previous runs, not much arm flailing going on, perhaps some more arm bending. But once he hits that top speed and the sparks and dust trail kick in, his run changes. He tucks in his arms, keeps them still, and he leans back from the speed he now has. It's like this top speed has been lifted from New Super Mario Bros. 2, of which we hadn't seen the like since Super Mario World and Super Mario 2. There's not as much head bobbing in 3D World, but if I had to liken this run to another from the series, it'd be those three games. In particular, when you defeat a castle in 3D World, you do this little victory run, and as soon as I first saw it, it made me think of Tom and Jerry. Remember from the beginning of the video when I said I'd come back to this? And the other bit with the hands by the side from Mario Bros. 2. This is it! This is the bit that we've come back to! It's like time travel! Among many things from 3D World, I feel the running animation is certainly an aspect which pushes towards a more 2D experience than a 3D one. So, is there a reason this is different? I mean, it certainly has a different feel to it than the forward-leaning scamper and the forward-leaning dash, but I suspect it was to give the game its own identity, much like 3D Land. It's also likely an attempt to experiment with crossover ideas such as bringing across that more cartoony run from New Super Mario Bros. 2. And I'll admit, it certainly works for this game. The much brighter and rich aesthetics certainly complement the more playful animations. I think I'd really enjoy it if Nintendo experimented a bit more with Mario's run like this. I think there are plenty of ways to convey that same rough around the edges hero idea without going by a checklist from previous entries, as 3D World has shown. This is without bringing up more miscellaneous titles like Mario & Luigi Dream Team, which feels like a smoother, simplified version of the 3D run, or fan games like Super Mario Flashback, which brings in a more stylized yet concise running animation while recycling that flat top speed from Mario 3, or his appearances in other games that aren't platformers like Super Smash Bros. It just shows that Mario is still versatile within a range, but exaggerated and cartoony movements suit him best. So we have a range of things. We have slow startups with less arm movement and less frames in 2D games, frantic arm flailing and stumpy leg loops for 3D games, a lean forward with arms back at top speed in new Super games, arms by the side for more stylized or quirky games, but always, always that cheeky, happy-go-lucky motif present in all of them. I'll be interested to see how you run next, Mario. This episode was funded by my glorious patrons, who get neat little rewards like helping to create the episode thumbnail, an overview of recent indie games with awesome art and animation, behind-the-scenes sneak peeks, early access to videos before everyone else, and, of course, your name in the credits, because you're part of what makes these videos fun for me to do. Consider supporting the channel through Patreon if you have PayPal and a spare dollar or three every month, and I guarantee it'll be definitely worth it. Love you, bye.